by Sheikh Muhammad Ibn al-Wahhab, rahimahullahu wa iyyah, wa askanahum fi jannat al-ula. The new print, as where we left off last week, which was in regard to that every single ummah, ba'atha Allahu ilayhim rasulan, for every given ummah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent messengers. Min Nuhin ila Muhammad, from Nuh to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya'muruhum bi'ibadatillahi wahdahu, and join upon them to worship Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala alone. Wa yanhahum an ibadati taghut, and prohibiting them from worshipping any false deities. والدليل قوله تعالى, and the proof is the statement of Allah the Most High, لقد ولقد بعثنا في كل أمة رسولا أن يعبدوا الله واجتنبوا الطاغوت. سورة النحل, verse number 36. ولقد بعثنا في كل أمة, we have surely sent upon every single ummah, nation, رسولا, a prophet, a messenger, and يعبد الله, to declare the people to worship Allah Ta'ala alone, واجتنب الطاغوت, and to shun that which is the false deities. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, as Shaykh Salih Al-Fawzan, he mentioned that all of the prophets and messengers, their call was one. He said, فَدَعْوَةُ الرُّسُلُ كُلُّهُمْ إِلَىٰ تَوْحِيدِ اللَّهِ, that all of the prophets and messengers, their call was one, which was the Tawheed of Allah. Even if you can find in their legislations some differences, but the asl of it is the da'watu tawheed, ifradullahi bil ibadah, singling out Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in worship. They all the prophets, they shared it. Naam, they may have some slight differences in their shara'i', but at the same time they may have some similarities in their shara'i', right? They may have some similarities in their shara'i'. In one of the similarity in the different shara'i', right, you can see as what? Example of, right, one thing that all the shara'i', they have it, whether it is a command or is a prohibition. One thing that all of the shara'i' have it. Right? This is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala legislated, al-qisat, al-qisas, has legislated in, like the Torah, likewise. And also it is prescribed in the Quran. What else? Huh? No, I'm talking about in regard to the shara'i', in regard to the furu', well, as I should say, in regard to the furu'. They all have, yani, the tawheed together. They have it similar, right? Meaning that's the same thing, that from the core, they have it. All the call of the prophets is based on the tawheed. Naam, the salah. Naam, that every prophet, alayhi salatu wasalam, they established the salah. It's something they have in similarity. Nah? Warning of the Jahannam, and what else? Warning of the Dajjal. Right? As the hadith say that every prophet warned its people against the Dajjal. Right? Every prophet warned his people about the Dajjal. And he say, and who remember the narration that we study in Usul Sunnah? Wa ana a'lamu, and I have more knowledge of the Dajjal than himself, about himself, that I have more knowledge of the Dajjal, or I have more knowledge of the Dajjal than the Dajjal. That I have more knowledge of the Dajjal than the Dajjal himself. Likewise, from those shara'i' that they have similarity is the rajm. Right? The rajm, the stoning. That it is in the Quran, it is in the Torah, and it is also in the Injil. As in the Torah, you will find it, the dalil, where in Sahih al-Bukhari, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when two Yahud, Right? A male and a female, they committed adultery. And they were brought to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he asked them, what do you have? What is the ruling in the Torah of this sin? Of al-rajm, of Allah, of zina. So they say what? He say, قَدْ حَدَّثُوا أَحْبَارَنَا, that our rabbis have innovated in this. That's what those two say. They say, our rabbis, they have innovated in this. Our rabbis had innovated in this. And they mention what was the ruling for the person that has done zina with them, is that they will blacken their face and they will put him on the back of the donkey and they will give them the ride around the souq or the aswaq. طيب. And the Abdullah ibn Salama, he was there. He said, Ya Rasulallah, O Messenger of Allah, call them to bring the Torah. Call them to bring the Torah. In Sahih Bukhari. And when they brought the Torah, the one of them placed his hand on the Ayatul Rajm. So they could only read from that which was before and after. And Abdullah ibn Salam, he told him, Da' yadak, remove your hand. Fadaka ayatul rajm. And here it was the verse in the Torah that was talking about the stoning. So that they all have some similarity and they have also some differences. As Allah Ta'ala mentioned, لِكُلِّن جَعَلْنَا مِنْكُمْ شِرْعَةً وَمِنْهَاجًا. Our new print tonight, بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ, is وَافْتَرَضَ اللَّهُ عَلَى جَمِيعِ الْعِبَادِ الْكُفْرُ بِالطَّاغُوتِ وَالْإِيمَانُ بِاللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made obligatory. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made obligatory. Meaning upon all of his servants. Ala jami'il ibad. Upon all his servants, Allah ta'ala has made. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has made an obligation upon all his servants. Tayyip, these two things. Al-kufru bit-taghut. Al-kufr bit-taghut, rejecting at-taghut, and we'll come to those inshallah. And the second thing is to have faith or to have iman in Allah. Wal imanu billah, and to have iman in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Qala Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, ma'ana at-taghut ma tajawaza bihi al-hadd. Hadduhu أو حده من معبود أو مطبوع أو مطاع. And as Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned that the meaning of a taghut, he said the meaning of a taghut is anyone regarding whom the servant goes beyond the due bounds or the due limits. Anyone regarding whom the servant, the abd, goes beyond his due bound, his due limits. Min ma'budin, whether it is someone worshipped, aw matbu'in, or it is someone that is followed, أو مطاع, or someone that is being obeyed. Someone that is obeyed. أما the first statement, which is وافترض الله على جميع العباد الكفر بالطاغوت والإيمان بالله, that Allah تبارك وتعالى has made an obligation upon all the servants, not only upon the Muslims, but upon all the servants. This is what Allah has made an obligation upon all the servants, to disbelieve in the false deities or in the taghut, and to believe, to have iman in Allah, To have al-iman in to have iman billah. To believe in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan hafidhahullah. He mentioned. He say, qala al-Sheikh rahimahullah. Meaning the mu'allif, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. He say, وَفَرَضَ اللَّهُ عَلَى جَمِيعِ الْعِبَادِ الْكُفْرُ بِالطَّاغُوتِ وَالْإِيمَانُ بِاللَّهِ ثُمَّ ذَكَرَ تَعْرِيفَ الْتَاغُوتِ. He say, the Shaykh Muhammad ibn al-Wahhab, he said, that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala made it obligatory upon all the servants, upon all the servants to reject Taghut, to disbelieve in Taghut, and to have iman, to have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And right after that, ثم ذكر تعريف التاغوت. And after that, he gave the definition of التاغوت. He mentioned the definition of التاغوت. فالتاغوت ذكره الله جل وعلا في آيات كثيرة منها قوله تعالى في سورة البقرة. He say, طاغوت has been mentioned by Allah تبارك وتعالى, the mighty and majestic, the mighty and the most high, in many verses. The word طاغوت has been mentioned by Allah in many verses in the Quran. In many verses in the Quran, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has mentioned the word at-taghut. From among them, that which can be found in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 256, all the way to 257. Verse 256. قال الله تعالى فمن يكفر بالطاغوت. شوف, that's the word, right? So Allah mentioned this in the Quran. فمن يكفر بالطاغوت ويؤمن بالله فقد استمسك بالعروة الوثقى لا انفصام لها والله سميع عليم. الله ولي الذين آمنوا يخرجهم من الظلمات إلى النور والذين كفروا أولياؤهم الطاغوت. Second time. والذين كفروا أولياؤهم الطاغوت يخرجونهم من الظلمات إلى النور, من النور إلى الظلمات, معذرة, يخرجونهم من النور إلى الظلمات أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون. أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون. So in this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned what can be translated to mean, فَمَنْ يَكْفُرُ بِالْتَاغُوتِ, whomsoever reject at-taghut, meaning everything or anything which is worship besides Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, anything that is being worshipped besides Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and that is pleased with it. Tayyip, anything that is being worshipped besides Allah and that is pleased with it. He say, whomsoever reject at-taghut and believes truly in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, فَمَنْ يَكْفُرُ بِالْتَاغُوتِ وَيُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ, and he truly believe in Allah, فَقَدْ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى لَنْفِصَامَ لَهَا وَاللَّهُ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Then he has grasped the firmest handhold that will not break, and Allah is all hearing, all knowing. Allah is all hearing, all knowing. And the second verse where at-taghut also is being mentioned is right after it, 257, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say, Allahu waliyu alladhina amanu. Allah is the guardian Lord of those who truly believe. Allahu waliyu alladhina amanu yukhrijuhum min adh-dhulumati ila an-nur. He brings them out.